Hi everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to learn how to disable the previous days in Datepicker using jQuery and some might use Bootstrap straight. Okay, that's cool. So here is the what we're gonna do is we first of all we're gonna create a text area where we're gonna be doing the Datepicker. The second thing is we're gonna create our JavaScript which gonna give us access to that Datepicker. Then we do what? We tell the Datepicker that please disable all the days before today, okay, before the current date. That's simple. Another thing is you might see or watch my tutorial and see other people doing it differently. The reason is everybody prefer to do things differently. Mine is gonna be just a single line. I don't want to make things a little bit complicated. I want to make something simple which gonna work for you. Just a few seconds, you're done. Then you proceed with your what? With your work. Okay, now we're gonna start with HTML saying that we're going to say head. Our head is gonna end here and we go jump down and create body. Body. Okay, then after body, then we're gonna say what? We're gonna close that body. After closing that, then we're gonna try to create what they call a text area, which is gonna be the input type equals to what we call Datepicker. We're gonna call it Datepicker just not to forget what we're doing. So the ID, I'm sorry, that should be the ID, and this is gonna be equals to, then we have our ID equals to Datepicker, then we're gonna have our name, which you're gonna, we don't need it necessarily, but you can put it there. After that here, the input type should be text, and ID we make it Datepicker. It doesn't matter the ID, the name, whatever you name it, it's up to you. But here, once we're done with this, we're gonna refresh and test if everything is okay. We test, then we have it. So now we don't have nothing there because we haven't told our JavaScript to do anything. So what we do, we go and put it here under before, between the header and between the closing header and the jQuery plugins we did here at import here. So we said script type equals to JavaScript stroke equals to text stroke JavaScript. Okay, you might see some people don't do this, but I prefer to do that. And then I go here and I say script. Okay, once I close that, I want to come in here and create a sample saying, let me say, we're gonna say create what they call document meant. Out here we say dot ready, then we say function. Don't get amazed if you find somebody else didn't do what I'm doing and they did it in a different way. As long as it works, that's what you need. So now we're gonna do this and I'll close that. After closing that, we're going to go here and we say come on, we're gonna say what? We're gonna say alert. So I wanna just test if our JavaScript is working. Before you do anything in JavaScript, don't write too much code without testing if your JavaScript is working. So once I save that, I'm gonna say yes. You can see, once you see this, just know that it's 100% working. So you're gonna start typing your codes. Okay, I'm gonna delete that. So then I say, I'm gonna come here and do this and come in here. And I do this and I come in here and I put a what hashtag and I paste what they call Datepicker. Then I say dot Datepicker. And if you're using date and time picker, you put date and time picker, but here we're using Datepicker. So you come here and also close and close and close. Once we're done with that, we know that everything's fine. Okay, let's save and try to test this. Okay. Doesn't work because inside here we told this guy that, you know what, we need something. So you know what, if you want to start doing some functionalities, that's when you do that. And you can see even the mistake we made, we don't have to do this, it's just to be like that. First of all, to work for us. Then we come and refresh. You can see it's working 100%. You can see, but you can see the dates are not disabled. You can see that what I'm trying to say. Oh, that's the future, and also the previous days or past days are also selectable. So this is what we don't want. We want from here to every to these all these days. We cannot, a person must not have any access to it. They are what clickable thing. So here we're gonna come and put those two, and then come here and say it's, we call it mini date, something like that. Mini date. We're gonna say mini date. Then we put colon space. We're gonna say zero. After saying zero, we put a space. We can put also this to be down. Then after that, we can save our stuff, and then we can refresh and say this. You can see all these days are what disabled. If you go here, you can't click previous. You can't click. You can click forward, but you can't click previous. You can select forward, you can see, but you cannot select what? Backward, you can see, I can't select anything from that. So simply means only this line, give it power to tell the what the thing that please don't select. But also if you want to do this, let me say, max. You see, if you say max date and put zero, let's see. Max date, if it's gonna work. You see, it's the same thing. If you want to disable the future dates, you just have to just put max instead of mini. You get me? So now you can see we can select the previous dates, but we can't select the what? The future dates. You can go backwards, but you cannot go forward after today's date. You can see. That's the difference between that. So I believe that helps, guys. And you can just, let me take it back. Don't worry, don't get scared to test. What if you put one there, what will happen? Okay, what if you put one, what will happen? Okay, I've put one. You can see it passed today's date, which is the 26th, then it started here. Disable this thing. So if you want 2, you put 2. If you want 3, you put 3. If you want 4, you put 4. If you want to disable things after maybe the 28th or whatever, that's what you're going to do only. So after every 2 days from the current date. So this is going to be after 3 days from the current date. So what are we going to do? So we're going to say current date. Even if you want to do the previous one, you do the same trick. So let me see. Now you can see today, tomorrow, and another day. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3. So if you want 5 days, if you want 7 days, even the previous, you can say, okay, I'm going to allow only 7 days, previous 7 days only. If somebody comes late into this, so you won't be able to select anything or to do anything. I'm giving just that. So also here you're gonna say, I'm gonna give a person 3 days from now, he can select until then. Those 3 days he can what? He can select depending on what you want. But that's what we did. Even if you want 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, let me say a week, after a week it's gonna be fine. Okay, I'm gonna refresh. You're gonna see everything is disabled here up until, that's why the calendar is gone now. Then we went to 2021. You can see it's 2021, so you cannot do anything until 2021. So you can set your calendar like this. Even if you say it's gonna be a month, the whole month is dead. Each and every current month can be dead, understand? And you can do maybe 2 months, you can do maybe 4 months, 6 months, 3 months, you get me? Or previous months before 1 month, you can do that. I'm gonna play with the 30 days. I tell the calendar. So 30 days from now, I want those 30 days to be off, scratched off. Okay, see what you're gonna do. You can see scratched off even next year first until the 25. Do you get me? From now, 26, 27, 28, 30, 31, that's 5 days. 5 days plus another 25 days, you get me? So the calendar is gonna open up on the 25th of next month, almost a month from now. Understand? That's the way you do that, guys. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you have any question, please, please drop it in the comment box below, because if we are able to do that, we know that whatever question you send, if we put in time and we fix it, or we do it for you, it simply means you're gonna stick on our channel. That's the reason why we are here to serve you in that matter. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video.